Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another Mommy Monday video. If you are new to my channel, my name is Melissa. I have a 10-month-old son named Lincoln, and yeah, we make mommy videos here. We also make beauty videos here and skincare videos here and lifestyle videos here. But once I had a baby, I decided to start making like baby mommy videos, and here we are. And this video incorporates both of my passions, babies and beauty. Okay, so my son Lincoln suffers from baby eczema, and this started probably around after his 4-month checkup, so maybe closer to 5 months. I noticed bumps on his face, and I thought that it was baby acne. And of course, worried mom, Dr. Google, I started Googling things, and I was like, I don't think he's supposed to have baby acne when he's this old. And I started to kind of freak out a little bit. So I made an appointment with our pediatrician, and she confirmed that it was baby eczema, which is super common for babies. It's super common at that age. It also kind of goes hand in hand with things like cradle cap. So if you look in their scalp and you see little flakes and things like that. But as always, if you have concerns about anything that's going on with your baby, their skin, their health, or otherwise, definitely talk to your doctor about it. So she recommended a handful of things, and what I remember from her list of recommendations was Dove and Aveeno. So I immediately after that appointment went to Target and picked up baby Dove and baby Aveeno products to test out on him. And it wasn't just on his face, so it was mostly on his cheeks, and it was red and bumpy, but it also kind of spread to his arms, slightly on his belly and chest, and his upper, like the top part of his thighs. So the first thing I used on him was baby Aveeno eczema therapy, and I actually ended up buying a whole bunch of Aveeno products. Like, I just bought the whole like Aveeno baby thing. This product worked well at first. It ended up working, and the bumps and everything went away almost, I don't want to say immediately, but within a couple of weeks. And then they came back, and I was like, oh no. And they slowly started to come back. So then I pulled out the baby Dove, and I actually don't have any of the Dove products like to show you a physical bottle of, because I hated the Dove stuff, you guys. They have baby Dove like eczema related products, and I didn't buy as many as the Aveeno. I think I bought a body wash and a lotion, and it just didn't seem to work well for us. It had a really thin consistency, and it didn't really do anything at all. So I ended up throwing those away. I probably should have given them to somebody, but I ended up throwing them away because they didn't work well for us. And then that's when the hunt began, because I didn't know what else to use. Those were the things that the doctor recommended, and nothing was helping his eczema. When you see your baby sitting there like scratching his arms or scratching his legs, you want to do anything you can to make it stop, because the poor thing, right? So I'm part of a couple of Facebook mom groups, and on my Instagram that you guys follow, I asked you guys, what do you recommend for baby eczema? And there was a couple of things that you recommended. So the first thing I saw was this Honest brand. So Honest brand eczema cream. Honest also has a whole skincare line for babies with a body wash and a lotion and shampoo and all that. But at this point I had already bought so many things that I was like, I'm just gonna try the lotion. So I bought this. I also bought Cetaphil Baby. So again, this one has a lotion and a shower gel. This, I just bought the shower gel. So I bought the shower gel or body wash to go with this lotion. Also, Aquaphor was another recommendation. This, and I was like, Aquaphor, what? Aquaphor is like a butt cream for like diaper rash. It's really thick, and we'll get to that in a minute. And then the last thing I tried was Tubby Todd. So we'll get to Tubby Todd in a minute, because that was the last thing that I tried. Let's first talk about Honest and Cetaphil. As you can see, I've tried a slew of things, and ultimately something did work. Honest. What I liked about Honest is this is pretty much the only eczema baby cream that got rid of the itch. So when I use this, he doesn't seem to itch as much. However, it doesn't get rid of the redness, and it doesn't get rid of the bumps. But the itching to me is what really matters the most. And anytime I use this, it does seem to soothe the skin, and it doesn't give him like clogged pores or acne or anything like that. It has kind of a medium consistency. It's not too thick, it's not too thin. And this is one that I find myself kind of going back to when other stuff stops working or isn't working as well. The Cetaphil body wash. So one of the things I've noticed with baby eczema is it flares up most frequently right after he takes a bath, or he gets exposed to water. So if we go to the pool and he has the chlorine in the water, so I limit his baths to once every 3 days instead of every day or every other day. Prior to getting all these products, I was just using Johnson & Johnson baby wash because that's what I thought you were supposed to use. It smells like a baby, it's great, right? Something about babies and smelling good, I like the baby smell. This one has the baby smell to it. It kind of has like a citrus, baby powder smell to it, but Cetaphil's kind of known for being good for sensitive skin. So far, so good. His skin doesn't seem to be as flared up after his bath when I use this as it was with Johnson & Johnson. Okay, let's get into Aquaphor. This was probably the most commonly recommended thing other than Tubby Todd, which we'll get into in a minute, that you guys recommended. Also, I do recall the pediatrician recommending this, but it didn't stick into my mind. What stuck in my mind was Aveeno and Dove, so that's why we tried that first. This works well, but I hate it, you guys. And the reason why is it is so incredibly sticky. It is literally the consistency of Vaseline. It doesn't sink into the skin. It doesn't like absorb or anything like that. It just sits on top of the skin and it's that sticky Vaseline consistency. So because I have to put it on his face and his arms and his legs, arms and legs, you can put like a long sleeve sleeper on and that seems to take care of that. But now it's on my hands and I'm like, what do I do with this? But when it sits like that on his face, he's inevitably gonna wipe it off. It gets all over everything. He wipes his face on my shirt or my bed sheets or his bed sheets or the couch or whatever he's nearby, and it gets everywhere. And because it's that oily Vaseline consistency, it kind of stains everything. However, it does seem to be the product that works the best out of everything as far as getting rid of the bumps goes, getting rid of the redness goes. It's just a pain in the butt to work with. Okay, the last over-the-counter product that we tried was Tubby Todd. Now, I will definitely let you guys know Tubby Todd is the most expensive thing and it's not available in stores, so you have to order it online. However, it's worth it. And this product is super hyped up. Everybody talks about Tubby Todd. All the mom groups I'm in, people talk about Tubby Todd. It's just everywhere. I see ads for it all over my Instagram. So I was kind of like had Tubby Todd in my mind. Their whole mantra is it's made with natural products, natural ingredients for sensitive skin. It's not gonna cause your baby to be exposed to chemicals or things like that. And they have these seasonal scents. So right now they have a watermelon scent and I want it so bad. They have a body wash. This is the hair and body wash. They also have a shampoo and a conditioner. They have a bubble bath. They have regular lotion. They have something called a dream cream, which is a thicker lotion. And then they have this all over ointment. I think the star of the show, because we tried it all, we tried the whole system, the whole shebang. The star of the show is the hair and body wash and the all over ointment. I think specifically the all over ointment is really, really key. It is such a good product. It works so well. It is very similar to the Aquaphor, but it has a different consistency to it. It's an all over ointment, so you can use it like the Aquaphor. You can use it as a diaper rash cream. You can use it on their face. You can use it on their legs. You can use it on their feet. You could use it anywhere and it's not gonna cause them to break out or weird things like that. It doesn't have a scent to it. It's pretty scentless. Oh yeah, it says fragrance free on it. Duh. It's made with avocado oil, coconut oil, things like that. But the consistency is definitely more like a thick lotion and a thick balm instead of that sticky Vaseline feeling. So this one sinks into the skin. It absorbs into the skin. It doesn't get all over the place when he rubs his face on me or the blankets or the couch afterwards. And it really does provide that hydration. And it does help with the itching and the bumps and the redness. If you're on the fence because of the price, they do offer little travel-sized things, a little travel-sized kit. Maybe test that out first before you make the plunge and you buy the whole thing. They did give me a 10% off discount code or link that I will link down below for you guys if you want to check them out. This is not a sponsored video, but it is a product that I like. I bought these products with my own money. So yeah, if you want to check it out, use the link. Don't use the link, whatever. Whatever you want to do. In the end, I will say that nothing over the counter completely eliminated the eczema. The only thing that completely eliminated the eczema was a prescription strength steroid cream that I had to go back to the doctor for. So at his 9-month appointment, I did bring it to the doctor's attention and I said, hey, you know, this eczema hasn't really gone away with anything that I've tried over the counter. There's certain things that work a little bit better than others, but nothing really, really made it completely go away. So she did prescribe a prescription strength steroid cream. I think it depends on the baby. It depends on the case of eczema and everything that's going on, but these are the products that I use. And if your baby has eczema and you've tried these things, you know, maybe you've never heard of Tubby Todd before, maybe try that one, but everything else is available at Target. I will link it all down below for you if you want to check it out. But I hope that you find something that helps for your baby, and I hope that you liked this video. If you have something else that you've tried that I didn't mention, let us know in the comment section down below so that we can check it out. Otherwise, I'll talk to you next time.